Hey everybody, and welcome to Yoga Shorts. My name is Lola, and I'm with the Sharon Forks Public Library, part of the Forsyth County Public Library System in Georgia, inviting you to take a step away from the busyness of your day, to take a break for yourself, to pause for a minute and take a nice deep breath, and hopefully relax and move into your day feeling a little bit more refreshed, or maybe you're wrapping up your day and ready to relax for the evening. So today we'll be practicing a couple postures on the floor. So I've actually got a yoga mat under me, but you don't have to have a yoga mat. You can use a nice thick blanket. You can use a couple of beach towels, depending on how hard your floor is. Just for a little bit of padding underneath your body as you do these postures. And as with any exercise, if it hurts, don't do it. If you have been given advice by a doctor on exercise, be sure to follow that. And we'll get started. First, we'll just start in our comfortable seated position, whatever that position is for you. I've got a couple items over here, a blanket and a towel that you can use up underneath your seat. Especially if your knees are a little high, you can give that a try, and we'll be using those again in a little bit. So first, let's get started in your comfortable seated position. Your hands can rest in your lap, or they can rest on your knees, whatever's comfortable for you, and you can close your eyes or lower your gaze. So the first thing we want to do is just begin to check in with our body. Take a moment to really step away from the busyness of the day. And as you get settled in, notice where your body is touching the floor. And feel the weight of your body settling in to those spots. And give a scan of your body. Let your attention travel up your spine as you sit nice and tall, relaxing your shoulders. Maybe even imagining there's a weight there, feeling a little bit heavier on the shoulders as they relax down. Check in with your jaw and release any tension you're holding there. Check in with your eyes, your forehead, your temples, that spot between your eyebrows. Let all the tension go from there. And begin to notice your breath. How does your breath feel today? We go through the busy day without noticing our breath much, but now's the time to take a nice deep breath. And let that breath go. Take another deep breath through your nose. And let it go. One more deep breath in. Sitting nice and tall. Exhaling, imagine tension from your day just floating away on that exhale. And then open your eyes. And first we're going to move into a position that's called table or tabletop position on all fours. And then we'll start some movement in that position. And so like I said, if you've got a towel, it's just a bath towel that's been rolled up, or a blanket, you may want those. You can watch through and see if you like them or not. First, let's just move into our tabletop position. So tabletop position, our hips are coming, our legs are coming underneath our hips, our hands coming down from our shoulders, and then your gaze is down on the mat in front of you. Your toes can either be tucked under, or if it's comfortable, your feet can be laying on the top of the feet. So first you'll take a big inhale. As you inhale, let your belly drop and your back arches a little and your head may come up a little. Inhale, so this is your cow pose. And then as you exhale, going back through that table position, letting the Halloween cat of your back, pressing a little with your hands, maybe your head drops a little, your back is arching. And then inhale back through that center position, the belly drops, the head gazes, eyes gaze forward, the head is up. Exhale, curl your back. Send your belly button towards your spine. Your head drops a bit. And inhaling back into your cow. And exhaling back into your cat. And just for a couple breaths, move at your own rhythm. So inhale, let the belly comes down, and then exhale as you move into your Halloween cat. So you two animals, your cow and your cat. Move at your own breath rhythm, inhaling deeply and exhaling completely. A couple more of these. And then come back to the center position in your tabletop and take a breath here. So our next position that we're going to move into is called child pose. And I'm going to show you a couple of options for your child pose. So child pose, in kind of its basic form, your big toes can come together. This is extended child pose. Your hips come towards your heels and the top body rests long on the mat. And inhaling, exhaling here. Now this position, you may find that this position is not super comfortable. So there are all kinds of variations. So the first thing you can do is go ahead and cross your arms and let your forehead rest here. Now if you find that it's too much for your feet and ankles, this is where this handy towel comes in. So I've just taken a bath towel and I've rolled it up. And I'm going to slide this right underneath my ankles. So the top of the feet and the ankles are resting on that mat. And I'm going to try that with my arms crossed here. So give that a try and see how that feels. And then another option, especially if you find that your hips are high, is to take a blanket. And I've got this blanket folded up, and I'm going to fold it up one more time. I'm actually going to take this blanket and I'm going to put it behind my knees. So I've got this position behind my knees. And I see that Jesse has come to join us. Here's Jesse making a visit. So I've tucked this underneath my knees. And I'm going to move back into the child pose with my arms crossed. Whichever position, as I come back upright, you choose that is comfortable for you, see if you can rest there for several minutes. So I'm going to leave this tucked underneath my ankles and let my arms come long. Your forehead can rest on the floor. If you find that your forehead doesn't quite reach the floor, here's another option. You can put your blanket here and let your hands rest here. But when you find your most comfortable position for child pose, go ahead and stay there for several breaths, at least 5 breaths. Noticing the air moving in and out of the back rib cage. And when you're complete, when you're ready to come back up into your out of your child pose, go ahead and move those items out of the way. And then come back to your seated position. So it's an opportunity to try the cow and the cat moves, which gives your back a nice, first an arch and then a curl in, and then moving into that child pose, which can be a really lovely pose. Once you find whichever position works for you, you can come into this position, use it as a resting pose, and spend some time there allowing your breath to move in and out of your back body. Invite you to give that one a try. You can do it also in a bed, or you can do it on a surface. Just protect your knees and you protect your back. Use whatever it is you'd like to modify, a pillow behind your knees, whatever feels good to you. So thanks for joining me today for our cow, cat, and child poses. I hope all is going well in your area, in your neighborhood, in your household. Remember to take a break for yourself, to take a moment to take a nice deep breath, inhaling and exhaling. And I look forward to seeing you next time.